What my IKEA kitchen looks like from the inside on a day-to-day. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Talia. This is Homervore. This is my creative outlet for all things design. Bear with me, I've been a little sick and my voice is a little off. Hopefully it sounds okay in this video. If you like this video and you like my content, then go ahead and give me a thumbs up if you feel like it and click that subscribe so that you don't miss out on any of my future content. So my favorite part of YouTube is hearing from you guys and interacting with you guys. And this video is actually a request of one of my subscribers. So I'm really excited to make it for you guys. It's the kind of video that I enjoy watching on YouTube, so hopefully you do too. So one of my subscribers asked for a video on how I organize the inside of my IKEA kitchen. I love making requested videos because I know that someone out there is interested to watch it. If there's a video you would like me to make, please DM me on Instagram. Leave it down in the comments and I will get back to you and I will plan it for one of my future videos, especially if it's something that I have available, like the inside of my kitchen. That all being said, let's get into the video. We have lived in this apartment now for 6-ish months, so many of the things inside the kitchen have shuffled and moved depending on how we like to use the space. I would say our kitchen has a really good amount of storage. I decided not to put extra storage. If you want to hear more about that, I talked about it in my last video, which I can link below. So when I made that video about the design process on my IKEA kitchen, I kind of touched on the layout and the reasons why I put certain things in certain places, but I didn't open up the cabinetry and show you guys inside. Not because I'm ashamed of what's in there, just because I didn't know if anyone would find it interesting. So I could probably get some drawer organizers and some cabinet inserts and some other things to help or make it more functional. But at this stage, this is exactly where I am. You guys know I'm about being real. I didn't clean up the kitchen cabinets before I made this video. So everything you're about to see is actual, real life, what my IKEA kitchen looks like from the inside on a day-to-day. Sorry if it's a little messy, but it's just exactly how we live and I want to show you guys. So starting with the pantry. Our pantry is at the beginning of the longest wall in our kitchen to the left of our refrigerators. The top half is shelving and the bottom half is 3 soft close drawers. On the bottom half of our pantry, we keep most of our food, our dry goods and our pantry items. This includes baking, snacks. On the top half, we have oils, condiments, cereals, cookbooks, bread and coffee. This part of our pantry also houses our router and some glassware and also our larger Tupperware. Our fridges. We have 2 IKEA refrigerators that are integrated and they're reversed so that the doors open inward to each other. Now the fridges are super cool in themselves, but something you guys may not know is that they include just a tiny bit of hidden storage at the top and bottom of each cabinet. So at the top, I like to keep our rubbish bags, cling film, all those kinds of things. I think I have some ice trays stored up there that came with the freezer, which we don't use. And then on the bottom, I have spare cooking trays from the oven that we don't really use very much, like a roast tray. And then on the other side, we have platters that we use for serving when we have people over, but they're big and kind of impractical to keep anywhere else. So I use these 4 little storage nooks for things that we don't need to get access to very often. Now to the right of the refrigerator is where our oven and cooktop are. There are 2 drawers on each side of our oven. The drawer bank to the right has 2 internal drawers within the top drawer also. So in the 2 drawers on the left of the oven, we have pots and pans and also Tupperware. Below the oven is 1 single drawer and I just use that for bakeware. So that is all my baking sheets. I have a vintage Pyrex. It's like a vintage Pyrex baking dish. And then just some accessories that came with our oven as well. To the right of their oven, there are 2 more drawers and those are the drawers I was telling you guys about. The top one actually has 2 concealed internal drawers within it. The bottom drawer we just use for pots, and strainers, mixing bowls, the top drawer we use for utensils, and the internal smaller drawers we use for smaller utensils, and also our dry herbs and spices so they're at easy reach when we're at the cooktop. Moving around to the right, we have the sink. Below the sink, we do have one fixed panel. We decided to fix because by the time we put the sink in and the plumbing, there's not very much room for another drawer there. So we fixed that panel and we put some oak handles there, and those oak handles act as somewhere for us to hang hand towels. Below that fixed panel, there is a deep drawer, and I use that to house our countertop bin. It has a wok and a larger fry pan in it. I also keep non-toxic cleaning items down there, things that I use every day, like to wipe down the cooktop and the front of the oven. From there, we move around to our dishwasher. To the right of the dishwasher is another bank of two drawers. This bank of drawers is similar to the other, where it has two internal drawers in the top drawer. The bottom drawer here we use for plates and bowls and other servingware. The next drawer up we use for cups. The internal drawer above that is for cutlery and flatware. We also have a tiny cutting board in there. I think I have some board oil. And the next internal drawer above that is our junk drawer. I know, I designed our kitchen with a junk drawer, but the thing is, I knew it was gonna happen and it was going to be somewhere. And I think it was better that it was a very shallow, concealed drawer. Therefore, we can't keep too much in it. And also, no one knows where it is. So even if you open up that top drawer, that junk drawer isn't obvious unless you know to pull it out. I figured while I was doing this tour, I'd also show you kind of how we organize our countertop for daily use. When I'm taking photos of my kitchen for content and social media, I tend to remove some of the clutter. But on a day-to-day, I mean, it's inevitable. We use our kitchen, and the things that we use every single day, I do keep on the counter. On our cooktop, we usually keep our coffee percolator, Italian-style coffee percolator. My husband's Italian. This is how we like to brew coffee. To the right of the cooktop, I really like to keep things that I use often while I'm cooking, but they're easy to reach. So wooden spoons, our flake salt, rock salt, white and black pepper, and just a spoon rest, so that I don't have to put messy spoons on my counter. Moving along, we have our toaster and our kettle. I also like to keep our diffuser here because when we open up all of our windows, and you guys know we have some big windows, I diffuse tea tree oil or peppermint, and that usually just kind of keeps the bugs out if there are any. We're up kind of high, we're on the third floor, and I find that we don't get too many bugs, but when it's really hot in summer and it's been really humid or it's been raining, mosquitoes tend to breed and they come in. So if I diffuse peppermint, I found that works really well. We then have our drying rack, the sink, a knife block, and also our food processor's out at the moment. So just to keep it real, I left it on the bench for this video because I've been using it heaps and why not? Next to that, we have our cutting board, so it's easy to reach my knives while I'm chopping things up. On the servery side of the bench, we have our water purifier. I just find it's easier to have it on that side. That way Frankie and Christian can grab drinks while I'm cooking or vice versa, and no one's getting in each other's way. The cups are to my right, so you don't really have to come into the kitchen. The drawer can be opened. You can grab the cup from the side, close the drawer and go around to the water purifier without disturbing whoever's using a giant knife on our cutting board. So that is it, guys. That is the inner workings of our IKEA kitchen. I know that it might not be as exciting as some of you would hope. I don't have a Cricut. I cannot make labels for every single thing in my pantry, and I don't know that it would be practical for me to anyway. But this is how we live week to week, day to day. I think we are pretty tidy within our kitchen. Christian's a retired chef, so he doesn't really like our kitchen messy, and I don't either. And I find our kitchen functions really well laid out like this. So I'd really like to know tips and tricks and how you guys lay out your kitchen, or if you have any ideas about how I could organize my kitchen internally better, would love to hear them. And if you have any suggestions for future videos, please leave them in the comments below, because it's literally one of my favorite things when I receive a video request and I'm like, I can do that. I will do that for you next week. I cannot wait to do that. So anyway, thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Bye. That is a lot of me out of focus too. Oh, you know when you do the passcode wrong once and then you just have to start over?